Twitchland, and welcome back to the Chaos Asylum. I am your host, the Chosen One, Lee Wyatt, and today is another episode of WWE 2K19, My Career, Episode 5, going for the Intercontinental Championship. Last time we were had our thing, a long thing happened. We did a 2-on-1 handicap match. Randy Orton came out of nowhere, RKO'd me 1, 2, 3, and I basically lost the United States Championship. Then I went on a tour in Japan, and I had a secret opponent that Daniel Bryan was hooking me up with. Come to find out, it was our old friend Cole. Did a match with him, and then we did a match with Nakamura, and then we did so good in both that Daniel basically was like, you know what, I'm going to put you in the main event with Nakamura and AJ. So then I did that. It was a triple threat match. Really good triple threat match. It went down. And then I won that one too. And then Kurt Angle came out and basically said, well, you know what? Then we went back and we're still on SmackDown. We had a feud with John Cena, which the funny thing was, whoever did the voiceover for John Cena was not John Cena. That was weird. Spoiler alert for that. I don't know why they didn't have John Cena do his own voice, but that was weird. So then he wanted to do a match at SummerSlam, so we did. Then you had to face Randy Orton to put your match on the line against John Cena at SummerSlam. You did. And then John's like, oh, you know what? Let's make it a submission match. Then you made it a submission match. And then at SummerSlam, you got basically drafted to Raw. So here we go. Elias, a side mission. Let's do that. Sounds like a lot of fun. I hope you did have a lot of fun. The guitar I broke last week. Want you only one? Was it your only one? No, I have enough guitar. That's too bad. I was hoping no one would ever have to hear you play again. Sounds like you want to step up on the right now. I have a busy night, but I think I have time to squeeze in Elias beatdown. Shouldn't take that any longer than one of your terrible songs. I have more important things. Let's take on Elias. And let me check everything out, make sure everything's good. And Gucci has I don't like saying that word. He isn't buying you a new guitar. Yeah, I'm not buying you a new guitar. Get out of here. Yeah, get in here. We're gonna fight, Elias. Yep, let's do this. Backstage brawl, baby. So how you doing, Sherelle? I took a little nap. It's funny. Like, right when you got off and whatnot, I came up, I watched the rest of my video on Netflix, and I came upstairs and took a nap until, like, 6. Yeah.
He hits the clothesline. Each of these competitors looks to gain momentum with a win tonight.
Oh, I gotta turn that down. That is loud. Let's turn that down to let's do 12.
Gets the early advantage. Could take this thing to a win.
Hi, everybody. How's everybody's weekend going so far?
I never get tired of watching these guys compete.
Beat it, Elias! Eat it, yeah!
Clearly on a mission here.
Am I now? Am I clear
on the move
mission?
Again.
I'm doing pretty good. Well, glad you took a nap. Yeah, me too. Oh, chair, still chair shot.
It's just a matter of time now.
Stupid. You should. You sound awake and ready to kick some ass, buddy. Yeah, damn right I am. So, and I'm ready for tonight too, for when we play some COD.
Long-term injuries for sure.
Or whatever we're playing tonight. Yeah. And I do have.
How do you make an impact?
Dang! I just like eat that, mother trucker. And I do have some, you know, the good Red's Apple, Red's Peach Ale, on ice, ready to go for tonight.
This man needs business.
Oh, elbow to the face!
Great
oh, snap!
Move.
Snappity, snap, snap. Oh no, wait! Oh, you gotta hold it. I forgot. Oh, you hit me with one steel chair shot.
Yeah! Oh, Buzz just barely got out of the way.
And that feels sucker. Oh no, do it. Sounds good.
Nice sidewinder suplex.
Thank you, Corey.
Oh, wow. Elias definitely tiring out there. This match is definitely testing his mettle, guys.
I don't think he was properly prepared for the dangers of a backstage brawl, guys. He's in a really bad way right now.
Yeah, he's clearly not on the right side of this match right now, which is a little surprising to me.
What is Buzz having score?
We're about to
slam.
Incredible. That should do it, Cole. There's no coming back from a slam of that magnitude.
Who wants to walk with Elias? Get up. I'll show you who wants to walk with you, boy. Get up. Come on. Come on. Get up. Get up. Come on, Elias. Walk with this.
From what we've seen and heard tonight,
feel stupid.
There must be serious injuries. And like, you can see that Elias is looking overwhelmed. I would be too.
He's in over his head.
Oh,
there's
no,
a good chance he can't recover from this.
There's no way he knows where he is right now. Heck, given the punishment he's taken, he probably doesn't even know his own name.
Oh, come on. Just put him out of his misery already. This is getting ridiculous.
You know, it's ridiculous. You're commentating, okay? That's ridiculous. Learn how to commentate properly, because you couldn't become a full-time wrestler. Feels still bad. No. Sprite!
So damaging.
Feels still bad. Hey, Elias! I think you need to cool off. Oh, crap.
Surprises him with
wrong
that
button.
Drop kick.
Wrong button.
His signature slam.
Pick up the fire. Pick up the fire extinguisher. You need to cool
this
off, Elias. Hey, what's up, security man? Who wants to walk with Elias? I don't know. Ooh. Oh! Dang, right through the table. Get up, Elias. Come on. Yeah, right. Dang, even the security guy's like, I'm out. He's like, this isn't worth it. This is not worth it, man. Come on, Elias. You and all the Miz Taraj people, get up, sucker. Hey, wait.
The action is officially on the move.
Oh, what's this? Use L to move the object box. Hold R2 to move without turning box. Square to shove box into your opponent. Press RL1 to let go of object. That is... Eat box!
He's inflicting some serious pain here.
That's funny.
Whoa! Oh boy, he is rolling. Oh! You have to possess a different type of focus to punish an opponent like this.
Oh, he's drunk, ladies and gentlemen. What the heck, Elias? Sounds good. That's new. Use the box. No. Oh, dang. I did not want to do that. You put him on the car? You throw him on the car? Oh, wait. Come on. Wait. Can we throw him into a car? Wait. Come on. Come on. Throw him into the car. No? Here. I don't want to see if you can throw him into a car. That'd be hilarious if something. Okay, here.
Creating some separation.
Oh man, you can't do nothing.
And the strike lands.
See ya. Elias. Brock Lesnar, Sasha Banks. Bray Wyatt, Sheamus, and Xavier Morning Woods. I mean, Xavier Woods.
Right to the midsection. He lands a jarring forearm. He's trying to mangle his face here. He's focusing on the face now.
See ya.
One move after the other. It's devastating.
Continue. Mr. Sasha Banksy. What did you say again, Sasha?
I really hope you win tonight and get your title match with The Miz. I'm so sick of him and Maurice running their mouths.
Maybe I'll be the one who finally shuts them up.
You'll be the first active superstar to be inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame if you can pull that off.
I better start working on my speech. I love this game.
Don't move. We have a great match coming up next.
We have one of our breakout talents against Bo Dallas.
Who will reign supreme?
Whoa. Oh, wow.
Get ready to feel the buzz. It's buzz.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Cleveland, Ohio. Weighing in at 265 pounds, the superstar.
Every superstar has a goal in WWE. And Buzz told me he's aiming high with his. He wants to have a career that one day is recognized with a spot in the WWE Hall of Fame.
It's way too premature to start that discussion, but his career is definitely trending in the right direction for that to at least be possible.
So the only thing I really gotta do, ladies and gentlemen, is beat Bo Dallas and become number one contender.
And his opponent, accompanied by The Miz, from Brooksville, Florida, weighing in at 234 pounds, Bo Dallas!
The Jizz. Nah.
Bo Dallas looking incredibly confident tonight.
further evidence that Bo Dallas is a bit delusional, Cole.
Yeah. Well, all I gotta do is beat Bo. That's a piece of cake. I thought it was gonna be a handicap match. I thought it was gonna be like me and Bo Dallas and Curtis Axel. But all right, I'm cool with this too.
To reiterate what's at stake here, if Buzz can defeat Bo Dallas, he'll earn a shot at Miz's Intercontinental Championship.
And keep in mind, per Kurt Angle's decision, if the Miz interferes on Bo's behalf, Buzz will still get his title shot.
Why doesn't Angle just hand Buzz the Intercontinental title? I mean, he's giving him every possible advantage.
I believe the goal is to make sure it's a fair match without involvement from The Miz.
Well, after this match, you and Buzz might be believing otherwise.
Hits with the clothesline.
Get Bo Dallas to red health, then pin him in ring.
It's all academic from here.
This better not be another screw job. Oh, God.
This guy has every square inch of that ring scouted to perfection.
You got this.
He just slammed him with
ease. Piece of cake.
Bo Dallas caught a little off guard there.
He's going to have to cut off his opponent's offense quickly.
He just has to make sure this doesn't get too out of hand for him. Sometimes, momentum has a way of permanently swinging one way. That's what he wants to avoid here.
Bo Dallas looking to finish this one early.
He got body on body there, but that's about it.
Remarkable.
Dang it.
Oh,
I pushed
your
buttons at the like right time here, too.
Shifted. Bo Dallas showing us how to get it done. He looks a bit off his game here.
Going for a pin.
I can't believe it. He just kicked out.
Nah, not yet. Too early.
And he's heading back in. Oh, I think this man needs business. He's inflicting some serious pain here.
Yeah!
Nice move.
The axe handle hits the mark.
And the instinct from Bo Dallas on display.
That packed a punch. What is it that Bo Dallas is looking to do to change his look at this point? I don't think this is how he envisioned this match going here tonight.
If he wants to win this thing, he's going to need to make some changes here.
Yeah. Oh, I think this man needs...
This might be it.
Cover.
One, two.
Kicked out at 2.5.
I thought he had him.
This is it.
Wait,
what's
Miz doing? What the heck?
Why would Miz punch Bo Dallas?
Wait a minute. The Miz is a genius. Since he hit Bo, Buzz got disqualified and doesn't get an Intercontinental title shot.
The Miz found a way around Kurt Angle's stipulation. I guess you have to give him credit for that.
Buzz is obviously upset about how all this transpired.
Tough night for Bo Dallas. He'll be fine. And besides, he won the match.
I'd hardly call that a victory.
All right. All right, you want to play, Mizzy. All right. All right, Mizzy. Coward. You know I'm coming for that IC title. You know you're going to lose. You know you can't beat me.
Yet again, The Miz finds a loophole to avoid defending the title.
I know. I'm just as frustrated as you are.
So what are you going to do about it?
I'd like to give you your title shot anyway. But unfortunately, I just got off the phone with Triple H. And he said that since Bo Dallas technically won, you don't get to face The Miz.
Triple H can just overrule you like that?
Unfortunately, when push comes to shove, he can. And I'm not surprised that he did, given your history with him.
All right, well, If Miz and Triple H are refusing to give me an opportunity, then maybe I need to make my own.
Opportunity?
No. Title. I know a guy who can help me out.
You do whatever you think you need to do.
Hey, Cole. I need a favor. It's short notice, but you did such a good job making the titles for BCW that I wanted to see if you could make me a custom title for me to use on Monday Night Raw. Fine. I promise to call you more often, not just when I need something. All right, I'll email you some design ideas, but one thing I do know is that my title will only be defended in
steel cage match, no disqualification match, ladder match submission. Ooh, let's do no disqualification matches. I love those matches.
Thanks, man. You're the best. Yes, I still have the lucky keychain you gave me. But I gotta run. Thanks.
Just create my own championship, mother trucker. You know, my own custom. What's up, Sasha? Baby girl. Wait, I have to design a championship? Holy crap. Okay, that's fun. Miss Taraj.
Just so you know, I still would have beaten you tonight, even if Miz didn't accidentally hit me in the face.
Yeah, it was a total accident.
How does it feel to be brainless by the Miz? Brainwashed by the Miz.
We're not brainwashed.
Yeah,
we have minds of our own. Stop doing that. You first. No, you first.
Yeah, you're definitely not brainwashed. It's too stupid. That's awesome. You get to design your title. Yeah. What's up, Miz? You little.
It must really suck to think that you have everything going your way, only to have someone who's better looking, more famous, and more talented outsmart you in the end.
This isn't the end.
Triple H has spoken. Thanks to me, you lost the match and your title shot.
Maybe I lost my title shot at your championship, but I'm going to be the first holder of a new title that's coming to Monday Night Raw.
Are they bringing back the Divas title?
Not quite. You'll see. Sasha, what's up, baby?
I can't believe what happened in your match with Bo Dallas. Somehow The Miz continues to find new ways to be the most annoying person on the planet.
I know. Hey, I actually have a favor to ask. I'm designing something big next week. Oh, debuting something big next week. And I was thinking it would be a good chance to have some fun at the expense of the A-listers couple. But I would need your help. You in?
You're offering me a chance to make Miz and Maurice look like even bigger idiots? Yeah, I'm in.
Yes! Okay. Thank you, Sasha. Okay, well, I guess we gotta decide a championship, guys. Here we go. Okay, let's, what's the 80s items? Scream for me! This is gonna take a bit. All right. take a look at the... Take all the time you need. It's your title. I like that. That's fun. No, wait, that board, that fits perfectly. Let's put that right. Oh. Oh, okay, no, I don't need nothing on that. Thank you. next. Yeah. Little Miss Bliss.
Hardcore.
I love that you like have to keep putting the name. Entrance, enter a name for your championship name design. Oh, I just did that. Good lord. see. Oh, action. Delete that. I hope they have the word the. No, I don't have the word the. Seriously? Okay. WWE. Rated R. That's funny. They don't hold the word hardcore, really. No. You know what? Then we'll just do it this way. We'll just have to make a little change to it. Oh, is it? The World Hardcore? Oh, okay, hang on. The word hardcore is in there. Is it? Did I pass it? Hold on. My brain's... Okay, wait. Maybe wait. Oh, there it is. Hardcore. Duh. WWE Hardcore. Yeah, I don't have championship, though. That sucks. Don't have the word champion. I think it'll say it itself. I hope. Yeah. WWE Hardcore Cruiserweight. What? What the hell's to have another name, really? Delete that. I don't even know other name. Thank you. WWE Hardcore. Alright, now we gotta go here. Cruiserweights. No, wait, we're not making it. Is that what that is? Oh, okay. What do we get? We got a preview. No. It's a pretty title, though. Ooh. WWE Hardcore Championship. Yeah. Okay, that's not bad. What? That was pretty dope. Yep, we just found it. Yep, right there. Singles, cruiserweights, except. I'm sorry it took so long, guys. Hey. What are you doing? Watch out, pup. Go on. I think that's kind of cool. You get to create your own. Okay. Now, that took a little bit, but don't worry, I'm not taking that away from, like, next week. God, this is going to be funny. Me and Sasha Banks making fun of the Miz and Maryse.
I am the Miz! And this is my lovely wife, Maryse. Say something to the audience, Maryse. That was wonderful, honey. You truly bring so much to the table and are certainly not just window dressing whose sole purpose of being in WWE is to follow me around from town to town, ironing my weird Matrix cloak dress that I wear. When my hand goes up, your mouth goes shut. When my right foot goes in, your right foot goes out. When my right foot goes in, you shake it all about. You do the stupid Miz dance and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Because I'm the Miz and I'm awful.
Yes. Yes, that's what I say too. I say that all the time. I'm like, oh, Miz is awful. Yes.
Since apparently our GM either thinks this is funny, which is impossible, or
is
just not paying attention to his own show, I am this close to dialing 911 to report two counts of aggravated character assassination.
Whoa, Miz. Sasha and I were just having a little bit of fun out here. No need to go overboard. I mean, besides, you didn't even let me get to the best part. Other than showing everybody how big of a goof you are, the whole point of tonight was to debut my new singles title.
Oh, it's so beautiful.
You see, since you refused to give me an Intercontinental title shot, and then Triple H backed your little scheme with loser Bo Dallas, I was forced to make a title of my own.
You created your own title? Wow. What do you think this is? WWE 2K19? This is real life. It's not pretend time. You don't get to make up your titles.
In so fact, pretty.
This is the most pathetic thing I've ever seen. And I've seen your matches on the indies.
You want to talk about pathetic? I think someone who refuses to defend their title, that's pathetic. Because even though this championship is brand new, it already holds more value than yours because I'm not going to hide behind it. I'm going to defend it against anyone at any time.
All right, champ. I have someone you can defend your made-up title against. Someone who's still waiting for payback for a broken guitar.
Like I said, anyone at any time. But you didn't give me a chance to explain that my title has some special conditions for how it must be defended.
What do you mean? Like the matches can only be held in high school gyms? Or there can't be more than 200 people in attendance?
Not exactly. My title will only be defended in no disqualification matches.
I would actually do. And it's funny too because I should say to Miz that he's awful all the time. So it's kind of funny.
We've been waiting a long time for this. The championship is up for grabs right here. Next, we have one of the best talents on the roster to date versus a formidable opponent.
The stakes are high and the superstars are ready.
Buzz wishes Sucks too tied to Raw. He will miss the competition on SmackDown Live, but he to face new challenges on Monday Night Raw. Yep.
The following contest is a no disqualifications match.
Dang right.
And it's for the WWE Hardcore Championship.
Yes!
The crowd is buzzing with excitement. Buzz is here.
Yeah! Oh my God, that looks so beautiful. Oh. You're right, it is so pretty.
Earlier today, I noticed Buzz backstage checking out some vintage Bret Hart matches on the WWE Network. He's apparently a big admirer of the Hitman.
Oh, Buzz has good taste, because when it comes to in-ring ability, there weren't too many better than the excellence of execution.
Earplugs.
He's got his own album, Corey. How can you deny what this man is all about?
When it comes from in the ring, bell to bell, absolutely, I've got all the respect in the world for what Elias is capable of. But when he strums his guitar, it makes my ears bleed.
I'd actually kind of like to see that.
It makes my ears bleed. WWE Hardcore Championship.
Introducing the challenger.
What's up, Izzy?
From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 222 pounds, Elias. Introducing the champion. From Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 265 pounds. He is the WWE Hardcore Champion, the superstar, the All-American Nightmare Lee.
Yeah, what's up, baby? What's up?
Plant your butts in those seats and get ready.
Here. There's no DQ, Elias. Remember that.
I can't believe Buzz just sprung this title match stipulation on Elias. It's completely unfair.
I actually think it's kind of nice to see Buzz pull one over on his opponents for a change.
I agree. We're so accustomed to seeing Buzz at a disadvantage. Finally tonight, he gets a match on his turn.
I thought broadcast journalists weren't supposed to be biased, but I guess I was wrong.
Walk with Elias. I'm getting the beat down right now, ladies and gents.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
No, you don't.
If you ask me, fellas, this championship match is among the most highly anticipated that we've seen in quite some time.
Yeah. Okay.
Back suplex.
Oh, looking for another, it looks like.
Like you, Corey, I've had this championship match on my radar for quite some time, and so far, I think it's safe to say that it hasn't disappointed.
No, it definitely hasn't, Michael, which is saying something, considering fans' expectations heading into tonight. I can tell you that they saw this as a potential match of the year candidate, and so far, I think it's delivered.
And he hits a monstrous powerbomb. Elias getting put in check here.
At this point, it's all about how he responds and potentially rebounds.
Guys, these superstars really do appear to be in peak physical condition here tonight, which isn't surprising considering what's on the line here in this championship match.
Eight steel chair. Nicely done. Eight steel chair.
Eight steel chair.
I gotta agree with you, Michael. These superstars are in tremendous shape, and from what I understand, the champ has been hitting the gym twice daily in preparation for tonight.
I heard the same thing, Saxton. Once in the morning, then again at night after the show, which makes me wonder when the champ actually sleeps, if at all.
Down with a powerbomb. I can tell you guys that this arena sold out in record time, and a lot of that has to do with this match in the ring right now. This is easily one of the most anticipated title matches in recent memory.
Why not that feeling?
The human body can only absorb so much of that.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
What does Buzz have in store?
We're
about to find out.
He's going to do it.
He hits it. Buzz brings everyone to their feet.
Now that's how you successfully defend your title.
Uh-oh, this might be the end of Elias tonight.
And maybe not.
Like you were saying, Michael, when news broke that this title match would take place here, I had dozens of people I know in and around the area calling and texting, just hoping I could get them tickets. That's how big this match is.
Isn't that cute? Your friends actually think you have enough pull around here to get them tickets. Poor people.
Poor people.
Yeah. No, he breaks out of it.
But does he have enough energy left to get back on the offensive? We may very well be seeing the finisher here very shortly, guys. And when that happens, you can bet this one's going to be over.
Hey there. We'll put like a double championship on the line, my hardcore title and his intercontinental title, or Triple H will, Like, strip me of this title and whatnot. Just
I'm with
be...
Corey. I suspect the finisher is on the horizon, and given how impactful that move has been as of late, I'd say there's almost no coming back from it.
All right, Michael, it seems like that finisher has become more and more impactful with each passing week.
If
that's even possible.
What the? No!
There's the Irish Whip.
Guys, in a title match like this one, on a stage as big as the one we're on now, you have to wonder how much nerves will become a factor.
How many times did I press this reverse button? He's still bad.
There are all sorts of things he can do to an opponent after a takedown like that.
All right, we're done. We're done.
What does Buzz have in store? We're about to find out.
He's going to do it.
Nice sidewinder suplex. That should do it.
Sidewinder suplex. Sidewinder. Yeah, you should do. Hey, Miz. One, two, three. What?
Out of it. Wow. That's pure power, guys.
All right.
Obviously, a great opportunity here for the challenger who can't afford to make any mistakes here tonight. Not when you're in the ring with a champion as dominant as this one.
Look at this!
clearly on a mission here.
To follow up Byron's earlier point, the challenger has to remember just how rare championship opportunities truly are here in WWE. A loss here could result in a trip to the back of the line.
Don't worry, Cole. This isn't the challenger's first rodeo. Everybody knows exactly what's at stake here.
Ref. Two.
He's got to be running on empty at this point.
It's not the end of the song for Elias just yet, guys.
Yeah.
A lot of people are saying the champion has never looked better.
He goes for the cover.
One, two.
Real close. Too close for cover.
That's all right, Cole.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Oh, God. Push me away. Another one. Oh.
Force on that slam. As Byron was talking earlier about the champ being a heavy favorite here tonight, I couldn't help but think back to the night Santino Marella defeated Ahmad.
What does Buzz have in store?
We're about to find out.
Oh, he's going to do it.
Oh.
It's a level of punishment that can only be described as
one,
severe.
Two.
Moment,
three.
Retains the title.
Oh, Miz is so mad. What are you doing, Miz? He's like glitched out over there.
These guys gave everyone their money's worth. Here's another look.
That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance.
One, two. No, I checked out.
I don't like to throw around a lot of praise, but my eyes tell me that might have been one of the great matches in recent WWE history.
One, two.
Hope everybody at home set those DVRs because that was a match you're going
like,
to want to watch again and again and again. Epic. There's good, there's great, and then there's downright unbelievable WWE action. Ladies and gentlemen, you just got a taste
here
of the unbelievable
coming. And still, WWE Hardcore Champion. The superstar, the All-American Nightmare Lee.
A well-earned victory indeed.
Well, no one's going to be walking with Elias tonight, I can tell you that much.
What a great match we just saw here on Raw. Thank you to everybody at home for choosing to spend part of your Monday night with us.
Yeah! Thank you, Sasha, for coming out with me and whatnot. I think it was only a one-time deal, but yeah. Months later. Uh-oh. What's going on?
You showed up a few weeks ago on my show acting like you own the place. You insult me and my wife and then cut every corner possible by creating your own title. Not to mention forcing Elias to compete with a random stipulation he wasn't prepared for. Well, I am sick of it. You want your match? You got it. My legitimate, illustrious title versus your second-rate imaginary title. At Hell in a Cell, we're done playing make-believe, because I'm going to show you what it's like to live in the real world.
Buzz has his match with The Miz, so what's Kurt Angle doing out here?
What's going on?
I'm glad you two are finally going to face off, one-on-one. That's right. Maurice, Elias, and The Miztourage will be banned from ringside. And since Buzz's title is on the line, the match will be held under his title stipulations. Which means it will be a no DQ match.
Yes! I don't know why it's glitching out like that. That's weird.
We've been waiting a long time for this one. The championship is up for grabs right here. Next, we have a real fan favorite versus The Miz.
Finally get my IC title shot. This Triple H flat out screw me out of my IC title also. It's weird how it was glitching, yeah.
The following contest is a no disqualifications match. And it's for the WWE Hardcore Championship.
And?
It's one of the hottest superstars in WWE, Buzz! Buzz is a man who has sacrificed everything to be here today, even living in his van at times when he was on the indies.
I know I'm not the biggest Buzz supporter, but even I have to admit, that's the definition of paying your dues.
Yeah!
Tell us all about The Miz.
The Miz is the man who single-handedly turned SmackDown from the B-show to the show. A star of stage, screen, reality television. Is there anything The Miz hasn't done?
Did The Miz pay you to say all that, Corey?
Absolutely not, Byron Saxton. I happen to be a hopeful for consideration for a Mizzy this year.
Really?
That's right.
Mizzy? Oh, come on.
That would be awesome, Corey.
That would be ridiculous.
Where would you put it? On my mantle with my most prized possessions.
Why are you encouraging him, Michael?
I would love to have him.
Wait, is my championship the only one online?
Introducing the challenger,
residing
in Hollywood, California, weighing in at 221 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, The Miz! Introducing the champion, from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 265 pounds, he is the WWE Hardcore Champion, the superstar, the All-American Nightmare Lee.
Wait, I thought...
Don't move, don't speak, don't even blink.
I thought Miz said he wanted my title for his, like, what? I thought it was title for title.
Here we go. Buzz's title and the Intercontinental title are on the line tonight.
Okay.
In a no DQ match,
at WWE Hell in a Cell.
Buzz has everything to gain and nothing to lose.
Stomp the crap out of the Miz. Yeah, you better get out. You're getting to beat
that. If that's true, then why did Miz issue the challenge?
Because, like most of us, he was tired of Buzz's antics and thought this would shut him up for once and for all. Little did he know that thanks to our wonderful GM, he'd have to compete under Buzz's ridiculous rules.
Well, none of this would have happened if Miz hadn't weaseled his way out of an intercontinental title defense. Nonetheless, that's all history, and certainly more history will be made tonight.
We've seen champions head into matches maybe a little too confident, only to be picked off in the end. And guys, I can't help but wonder if we're going to see that again here tonight.
Yeah, my hand. Surprise! Boing!
Oh, a clothesline!
Not done yet.
Another one!
Speaking of champions heading into matches a bit overconfident, one of the most glaring examples of that would have to be the Honky Tonk Man's attitude heading into his Intercontinental Championship defense at SummerSlam 1988. We all know what happened to him on that night.
You are so right, Michael. That was great, of course, though. It wasn't so great for the Honky Tonk Man, who ended up losing his championship to the Ultimate Warrior in fewer than 30 seconds.
Guys, a loss here for the champion would be incredibly embarrassing, especially considering all the trash talking I'm told that's been going on behind the scenes. I don't want to reveal my sources, but let's just say there's been some pretty harsh words being tossed around.
Oh, the reversal by the Miz. Plenty of force behind that strike. Taking the boots to him. I don't know who your sources are, Corey, but it wouldn't surprise me at all to learn that the champion has been a little cocky heading into this one.
And there's nothing wrong with that, Michael, especially considering just how dominant the champ has been of late. When you're that good, you have every right to blow your chest out a little bit.
The Miz with a nice reversal. A big fight feel inside this arena here tonight for this huge championship match. And so far, I'd say these competitors have brought their A games. Got to get back in the ring.
We might just have a count out on our hands, Cole.
Whoa, he gets out of it.
He's at another level right now, Michael.
Dang, I looked when I was...
Oh, he's such a tough target. Taken down with authority.
Haha. Yeah, make sure that you punch his face, laugh out loud, as in the Miz... Mizzy's dorky face, laugh out loud. You can win the IC title! Yeah! Yeah!
Message delivered. A bad place to be for the challenger. His hopes of winning this match appear to be dwindling in a hurry.
Don't write him off just yet, guys. From what I see, these guys are pretty evenly matched at this point.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, a devastating shoulder tackle.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
What does Buzz have in store?
We got it. Incredible.
Did you guys feel that too?
A big fight feel. Pressure cooker situation. WWE Universe hanging on every move. He's displaying classic offense here. Now that's how you make a statement. This is a grueling championship match. Nobody wants to lose this opportunity.
Get up, Miz. Let's go.
The damage has been done.
Get up.
Oh, drop down.
Shoulder tackle does the job.
Perhaps he's thinking the ring can't contain what he has in mind here.
Oh, crap.
The champ starting to feel the pressure a bit. Guys, he's going to have to turn things around quickly if he wants to win this thing.
I've never count this guy out, but I'll tell you what, he's not looking so hot right now. He's really going to need to find a way to get back in this thing.
Yeah, but there's the pin. Title on the line. And the champ kicks out. Not yet.
Why does that guy look dead? Yeah.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
Get up, Miz. What the?
He's seriously in serious pain here.
I pushed triangle and he didn't even grab it. What the?
Both these superstars appear to be operating on fumes here, guys.
Come on. I'm in reverse. Jeez. Are you kidding me? How many reverses do you have?
This guy. The champ being pushed to the brink. We could be looking at the end of this championship run.
And things look bleak right
punch
now.
Me?
I think this man means business. The champ needs to hurry here. The Miz got the worst end of that stick. He's in some serious pain here.
That might just be the final nail in the coffin.
The champion into the cover. Two. I wouldn't have been surprised if that was it. Wow. Wow.
That's pure power, guys.
You have to possess a different type of focus to punish an opponent like this. Look out. Here's a cover.
Could be it.
Two. He's got to do more damage before he can get a three count.
It's hard to believe, but it looks like he still has some gas left in the tank.
That'll have you worrying about long-term injuries for sure.
Yeah.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting. Absolutely flattened him. Perfectly executed.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
Uh-oh. Oh, incredible power. Wow, what a vertical suplex.
Wait, what are you doing, ref? What's going on? What happened? I'm kind of confused.
Buzz have in store. Using all his power to drive into the man.
Can he finish him off here?
What does Buzz have in
what
store?
What the? Don't do it. Spit alley.
Business. The Miz getting outclassed here tonight, guys.
Use Miz's own finishing move against him. Use Miz's own finishing move against him. What? Wrath.
Going for the
one, two, three.
There's the pinfall. And the victory.
That was embarrassing, Miz. You just lost to your own finish.
Hard to imagine, but that match was even better than advertised. Here's another look at that history-making encounter.
That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance. I could watch highlights of that one all night long. One of the great WWE matches I've ever been able to watch.
You're looking at the first ever superstar to simultaneously hold the Intercontinental title and, for lack of a better term, the Buzz title.
Yeah, his carry-on bag just got a little bit heavier.
Yeah, if I were the Miz, this match would be under protest. It should have never taken place under these rules.
Well, it did, and now we have a new champion. You can protest all you want, but it's not going to change what happened.
Give me your title, boy. Yeah. Oh, God. Take
did
off.
It. You finally shut up The Miz.
I don't know about that, but I did beat him and take his Intercontinental title.
That's good enough.
But thanks for helping me along the way. We make a pretty good team out there.
We did.
If you ever need someone to dress up in a ridiculous costume to send a message to one of your opponents, I'm your guy.
I'll remember that.
Hey, Sasha. You mind if I have a moment to talk business with the champ?
Yeah, no problem.
I was thinking about calling myself Champ Squared, actually.
Yeah, about that. Not to put a damper on your big victory, but according to WWE regulations, you're only allowed to hold one singles title at a time. I could try to circumvent the rules and let you hold both, but Triple H would just force you to vacate one anyway.
You really know how to ruin a party.
I'm sorry. So which title would you like to keep? That had to be a tough decision. If it's any consolation, I'll give you the rest of the night to celebrate with both championships.
Thanks.
Well, I mean, I was working so hard to get the Intercontinental title, so, you know, why not? You know, shit. The Miz is one of the most deserved Intercontinental champions of the WWE history. Hey, I was reading that. Oh, Baron Blade, jeez.
Hey, Intercontinental champion. That was quite a win you had over The Miz. Yeah, I know we still haven't talked, but I wanted you to know I've continued to watch you every week. And I'm not going to stop. No matter what happened between us, you'll always be my protege. Oh, I don't know if you heard, but I had to close the doors on BCW. Attendance took a big hit without you and Cole, and I guess some people didn't want to work with me anymore. Apparently, controversy doesn't always create cash. And I'm not telling you this for sympathy or anything like that, just thought you might want to know. Anyway, congrats again. Hopefully we can talk soon.
Buzz, you're Intercontinental Champion! Do you know how cool that is? I mean, Bret freaking Hart was Intercontinental Champion. The Ultimate Warrior, Shawn Michaels. Now you! And none of them held the title I designed for you at the same time. Well, I mean, to be fair, it didn't exist then, but still, you get my point. What you've accomplished is... Oh, man. I'm so sorry. I'm just so excited for you. It's unbelievable. I mean... I wrestled you in bingo halls in front of 20 people for 15 bucks and a hot dog. And now we're here. I'm sorry. I'm just cutting onions right now. Listen, I'm sure you're out celebrating, but I'm between Japanese tours right now, so hit me back up when you get a chance, okay? I miss you, man. All right. Bye.
Finishing skull and crushing finale and gonna eat your comb bread. Yeah, you're right. You was busting your ass for the Intercontinental title. Yeah, so why not, you know? Cole, man, I miss you too, Cole, man. Cole's one of those guys that, like, you just get used to his character. Wait. You get used to his character. Ooh.
Some big news happening on the indie scene involving BCW and Baron Blade, and unfortunately, once again, it's not anything positive. I have it on good authority that BCW will be closing its doors, and all future scheduled events have been canceled after Baron's double cross of his protege Buzz played out in front of a worldwide audience on NXT. Not too many wrestlers, or fans for that matter, were lining up to do business with Baron. Reports are that attendance dropped drastically and debts were owed to various wrestlers and companies, which led to Baron trying to right the sinking ship with his own personal finances, even putting his house on the market. But apparently it was too late for BCW, which is unfortunate because at one point it was a viable option for wrestlers outside of WWE and also another choice on the menu, if you will, for wrestling fans. Now, despite how you may feel about Baron Blade, this is no time for celebration, okay? In my opinion, the more wrestling that's out there, the better. And I'm not going to rejoice when someone loses their livelihood or their home, despite any questionable decisions they might have made in the past. While Baron Blade has hit a rough patch, it's been quite the opposite for his protege, Buzz, who's had a ton of success since being traded to Monday Night Raw, most recently defeating The Miz at Hell in a Cell in a title versus title match. Now, if Buzz can avoid injury and any of the other setbacks we've seen superstars suffer, then the sky's the limit for this blue chipper. I just hope that with the loss of his mentor coinciding with his quick rise to the top, that someone is there to keep his ego in check and also look out for his best interest. But when you have instant success like he's had, I have no doubt there's a giant target on his back in that locker room.
God dang it. Let's see what's going on in chat. You made a good choice. Hello, Sherelle, as well. So how have you been doing, Xavier? Then the next night,
hey champ, just wanted to let you know we're wrestling tonight, and it's for the title.
Yeah, Kurt actually texted me about it this morning.
My dad texted you? He never responds to my texts because he says he's not really a texter. Huh, that's odd. Anyway, want a picture together?
Sure, I guess. Is this something you normally do with your opponents?
Not really. I just thought it would be a nice memento for you to have after you lose your title tonight. That's a keeper. I'll text you the pic.
Thanks. Actually, what? On second thought, I'm not really a texter.
I'm really good. Enjoying this, Billy? Enjoying this game, Billy. It's very exciting to watch. Thanks for asking. I gotta put my ice.
The championship is up for grabs. Coming up next, it's Jason Jordan against an imposing adversary.
There is nothing better than championship caliber matches.
The Miz is one of the most Intercontinental Champions WWE history, with a title reign spending over 600 days that makes Buzz versus over 8.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the Intercontinental Championship.
Oh, this should be good. Hey, Byron, here's a little trivia question for you. Who's the only person with the NXT, SmackDown, and Raw tag team titles?
Huh, I know. Jason Jordan.
For the first time in your life, Saxton, you're right. He read it off my notes. Fair point. Jason Jordan joined Raw in 2017 as general manager Kurt Angle's son. What a wonderful moment
you
that was.
The news.
I know. It was the proudest thing I've ever done. What a beautiful family.
Feel the excitement! Buzz is here!
Yeah!
There's been a lot of coverage on Buzz's falling out with Baron Blade, but less is known about Buzz's other mentor, his father. I do know, however, that Buzz has an old saved voicemail from him that he uses as motivation before his matches.
Saxton, have you been snooping through people's phones again?
No, Buzz told me about it, I swear.
As well, it is a good storyline. You're welcome, Cheryl. That belt looks good on you. Thank you, Cheryl.
Introducing the challenger from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 245 pounds, Jason Jordan.
Yeah.
Introducing the champion from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 265 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, the superstar, the All-American Nightmare Lee.
Yeah! Guys, come on, watch out. Be good. Watch out.
Stay right where you are, people.
Here. It's funny, my tights kind of match this white and black. Black and white. The new Intercontinental Champion, the All-American Nightmare Lee. Yeah. Okay.
What did you guys think
right
of
into it.
The decision to keep the Intercontinental title rather than his custom title?
I mean, it was a no-brainer. Do you want a prestigious title that guys like Bret Hart and Shawn Michaels once held? Or do you want a self-awarded, made-up title that has no history?
Yeah. I wish he could have kept both titles, but I respect Kurt Angle's decision. At least Buzz will always have his title as a keepsake.
Nonetheless, that decision won't matter at all if Buzz slips up tonight and Jason Jordan walks away with the championship.
He's inflicting some serious pain here. So damaging. The human body can only absorb so much of that.
The challenger's taking on some offense. He looks incredibly motivated, though. Don't expect to be down for long.
Look at this. Right to the body.
Ah!
Just a ruthless power bomb right there. He's showing absolutely no pity now, guys. Jason Jordan getting pushed to the limits here.
He doesn't want to let this match get out of control, guys.
This match is trending in a bad direction for him right now, guys. He's going to want to make some changes if he wants to stay in.
This match certainly isn't trending in the right direction for him. He's going to need a change in momentum and fast. I know anything is possible, but I just can't envision a new champ being crowned here tonight. The champ just comes into tonight with too much momentum.
He hasn't done nearly enough to get the pin yet.
Gonna take more than that.
Executed perfectly. Byron, I agree that the champ comes into tonight with a great deal of momentum, but like you said, anything can happen. We've seen champs get upset in the past. Who's to say it can't happen again here tonight?
Agreed. I don't think anybody expected Eddie Guerrero to defeat Brock Lesnar for the WWE Championship back in 2004, but hey, it happened. And it's further proof that any superstar can...
What does Buzz have in store?
We're about to find out.
He's going to do it.
He hits it. Buzz brings everyone to their feet. And Jason Jordan forces his way out.
He needs to change something fast, guys.
Seems to me, guys, like we're just moments away from seeing the finisher, which could obviously put this match on ice. Oh, taken out with a power bomb.
What does Buzz have in store? We're about to find out.
He's going
to
do it.
I think this man means business.
Jason Jordan he's
got him covered.
The finisher could absolutely end this match, Michael, as you were saying. But it's not
the singles match has come to an end. Wow. And here's a look back at some of the action from the previous match.
Three.
That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance. Count yourselves lucky, people. You might watch WWE for years only see a match that good a few times. Epic.
You think Jason Jordan still wants to take a selfie with Buzz now?
Real classy, Byron.
What the heck?
Yeah, Bray Wyatt.
Buzz. It's the sound of the cicada emerging after years of slumber from their underground existence. just as you have emerged from the underground and made your presence known. Unfortunately for the cicada, when it tunnels its way to the Earth's surface, it only has mere weeks to live before it is eaten by a predator. Well, I am that predator. For I am the eater of worlds. You should have stayed underground, my friend. Because now I am coming for you.
This has the potential to be a very bad situation for Buzz.
What the? Bray Wyatt? Yeah, okay.
Hey, not to be weird or anything, but I've been meaning to ask you since you got to Raw. What's up with you driving this retro van everywhere?
It's just what I'm used to, I guess. I kind of lived in it when I was on the indie scene.
Kind of?
Okay, I definitely lived in it when times were tight. And then when I signed with WWE, I decided to fix it up. Keep it running.
Interesting. And the bug logo?
Oh, this used to be my dad's work van for his exterminator business. Pretty much the last thing he gave me. I guess his way of supporting my crazy wrestling dreams.
That's cool.
I mean, other than the fact that it still kind of smells like pesticide.
Well, I think your dad would be really proud of what you've accomplished so far.
Yeah. Yeah, me too.
Thanks, Bailey.
Don't move. We have a great match coming up next. We have a real fan favorite taking on some tough competition.
Oh, we aren't going anywhere.
The superstar known as Buzz is here.
Making his way to the ring from Cleveland, Ohio,
yeah.
Weighing in at 265 pounds, the Intercontinental Champion, the superstar, the All-American.
Is it me or does this guy's 15
Nightmare
minutes of fame expire?
I think it's just you because, just like a good mattress, Buzz's success seemingly has no expiration date.
Is that why our chairs have bed bugs, Saxton?
Why aren't you a bed bug, Saxton?
Face the facts, man. This guy may never, ever win another match.
And his opponent from Queens, New York, weighing in at 223 pounds, Kurt Hawkins.
You know, guys, some people were just built to be WWE superstars. And if history's taught us anything, Curt Hawkins was probably more likely built to be an electrician.
You know, we talk a lot about Asuka's winning streak. Curt Hawkins has one of the great all-time losing streaks. I don't think the guy's won a match in his career.
Well, that just means he's got more motivation to capture that one elusive victory.
Or change careers.
Kurt Hawkins is 0 for the century. Who cares?
Byron, why does Hawkins carry that?
Time to give you another loss there, boy. Kurt Hawkins.
As Buzz is set to take on Kurt Hawkins in this non-title match, we have to discuss what happened last week when Bray Wyatt appeared and essentially threatened Buzz.
That was creepy. I don't have a good feeling about what might happen next.
When the Eater of Worlds sets his sights on you, nothing good can come from it.
You have to wonder if the specter of Bray Wyatt looming over Buzz will be a distraction from him going forward.
Normally, I'd say it would be a concern, but luckily he's facing Kurt Hawkins, who's on a bit of a losing streak, to say the least.
Offense like this is exactly how a competitor takes control of a match. Just a clubbing axe handle. One move after the other. It's devastating. He's taking some offense. With these two guys, we all knew this was going to be an all-out battle.
Hey, you're going to absorb some punishment in a wrestling match. It just goes along with the territory, and he knows that. I doubt he's all that concerned at this point.
I think a lot of people right now are scratching their heads wondering how he let this match get so out of hand.
From what we've seen and heard tonight, there must be serious injuries. He's inflicting some serious pain here.
Oh, no, not this again. Dang it.
Oh, I think this man means business. He's in a little bit of trouble now. He doesn't want to absorb much more punishment if he wants to win this match.
He's really starting to look fatigued here, guys. And when that happens, your whole body starts to give out on you. He's going to need to be careful here.
But if you're counting him out now, you haven't been paying attention. He's
got the shoulders down. And he's able to get the shoulder up.
And we continue.
He's inflicting some serious pain here. There's no recovering from that.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
Whoa, Kurt Hawkins dodged that one.
Spear!
Oh, and he connects. There's no reason to lose your footing on a move like that. Come on, toughen up.
Oh, well, right into it.
And there's a bone-crunching drop.
Gonna hurt,
tear your hamstring. Lariat.
There we go.
He's going to have to act faster to stay in this. He may very well be running on instinct right now.
Oh man, what a beating he's taken. You can see the lights are on, but clearly nobody's home.
You hate to give up on a guy, but there may be no way around him taking this loss here tonight.
Don't do it.
It's gotta be hard to rebound from that one. He's making a statement here with this attack. What does Buzz have in store? The human body can only absorb so much of that.
That's what he was looking for, Michael.
The force of that impact should put an end to this match right here.
Just go for the finisher already. I don't understand the delay. The object.
What does Buzz have in store?
We're about to find out.
Oh, he's gonna do it.
Talk about sending a message. What power. What a slam. What damage. Look at this. The pinfall and the victory.
Yeah.
Let's take another look at what made that matchup so memorable.
What a 946-0.
That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance. This entire match was just one big highlight reel, and I didn't expect anything else.
Not again! It's the sound of insects buzzing all around us. But unlike you, they serve a purpose. My fireflies light up the night so maggots can seek out and dine on rotten flesh and waste. But you? You're simply a parasite, feeding off of everyone you encounter and giving nothing in return. Your lineage itself was built on someone whose sole purpose was to leave death in their path, to exterminate. And I find that amusing, because that is exactly what I'm going to do to you. You see, at TLC, you can leave your precious title at home. I'm not concerned with that trivial ornament. What I am concerned with is your demise. Your extermination.
I'm not going to stand here and let you try to play mind games with me. But what I will do is accept your challenge for a match at TLC.
What is happening?
I have no idea, but this is a sick man we're dealing with.
Luckily, we're not the ones dealing with him. He's Buzz's problem now at TLC.
Curt Hawkins' losing streak continues, laugh out loud. You're on a winning streak since you became the IC champion.
Yep.
It's broken, Matt Hardy. He has been woken. Oh,
Yep.
Yeah. Hey, Matt. Sorry to interrupt. Whatever it is you're doing.
What does it look like? I'm rosining my violin bow as one does.
Yeah, of course. Listen, I've got a match coming up against Bray Wyatt, and I was just kind of hoping you might be able to give me some advice.
Brother Buzz, are you woken?
I don't think so.
If one is not woken, then there is no hope in combating a force such as the monster you speak of. And even I, who is supremely woken, have lost many battles to him in the Great War.
Okay, so how do I become woken?
That is like asking how your vessel breathes the air. It must materialize on its own. Or there is the technique of a jump to the multiverse, but all this rosining about and dispensing of wisdom has given me much weary. I must retreat to my quarters. Good evening, compeer.
Okay, thanks. I guess.
Well, I'm not sure that was very helpful for Buzz. Coming up next up.
Oh! It's Bray Wyatt!
So, Bray? That was cool. How he did that with the ring. Yeah, I know, right?
Stop, Wyatt. And they're ready to go in the backstage area.
And guys, nobody walks away from a backstage brawl better than when they went in. That's including the winner.
Huh? Come here.
Reeling from a forceful shove there. And sent crashing back down.
Fine.
This can be business.
Yo, hey, what's up? How you doing?
Action is on the move now.
They're on the move again.
Ding dong! Walked right into it. Oh, God. Walked right into the room and got it.
I don't want to know what that feels like.
Bray Wyatt on the
get
defensive.
Get Bray Wyatt to your van in
but
the
he's very aware
lot.
Of who he's in there with and what he has to do to rebound.
Who doesn't love when a fight breaks out in the back? I mean, other than you, Saxton. Mr. Goody Two-Shoes over here likes to keep it in the ring. Whatever. He chooses to shove his opponent.
Dang. Pump handle.
Up and oh no.
You have been woken.
It's devastating.
Oh, not through the table. Oh.
Jeez. The action is officially on the move.
Never a dull moment around here.
Oh, crap. That did not work.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
The strikes have a little extra on them tonight.
Ooh, what an update.
Oh, jeez.
No.
Oh, so damaging. Nobody comes back from this.
Gotta cool down.
I'll be shocked if
cool down, Bray Wyatt. You need to cool down. It says, go take Bray Wyatt to your van in the parking lot. I believe the parking lot is right here. So where is the van? Oh, there it is.
Never know where the action is going to take us.
See, yeah, I'm escaping. I'm out.
Action is on the move now.
Get Bray Wyatt to your van in the parking lot. Okay, well, the van's right here. Hello? Throw him into it. I guess
so. In the face. Uh-oh.
Watch out.
Oh, shoulder first.
Guys, you don't think.
Oh, no,
you
please.
Don't think.
I can't watch.
I like this. Oh, my God.
Uh-oh.
Is he really gonna do this?
This is bad.
Oh no.
No, this is sick.
Sister Abigail!
Sister Abigail!
Come on now!
Please don't do this!
Oh my God!
What kind of twisted individual would destroy something that meant so much to Buzz?
Bray Wyatt would. The man operates under a different set of rules.
I can't believe this.
There you see Buzz arriving for his match tonight at TLC versus Bray Wyatt.
Yeah, I noticed he wasn't driving his van because Bray Wyatt torched it.
And that wasn't just any van. It was a gift from his late father. You have to imagine he'll be seeking revenge on Bray Wyatt tonight.
Okay. You want to catch the only thing that my dad left me on fire. All right. Fine.
I know you were cleared by the doctor, but I need to personally make sure you're both physically and mentally fit to compete tonight after what Bray Wyatt did to you last week.
There's nothing that can stop me from getting revenge on Bray for what he did. Nothing!
Hey.
I've had my share of battles with Bray Wyatt in the past, so I know how you're feeling right now. Did he ever set fire to something valuable of yours? No. And I'm sorry about that. If I could give you some advice, it would be to drag down and the venom placed deep within yourself, which I implore of what he did. No, it wouldn't. Good luck, and remember, when it comes to Bray Wyatt, be prepared for anything. I will be. Why aren't you talking, Finn? What the heck? Bailey.
Hey, you probably don't want to talk about it right now, but I'm sorry about what Bray did to your van. I know it meant a lot to you.
Thanks. I appreciate you saying that. Wait. Were you going to hug me because that's your thing, or because you're worried about what might happen tonight?
More the second one.
I'll be fine. The only person anyone should be worried about is Bray Wyatt.
Bray! What the...
Where is Bray taking him? Somebody needs to stop this.
He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole wide world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. Are we at the Wyatt compound? Follow the figure with the bat. Follow the figure with the zombie. With the sledgehammer. The sledgehammer's Triple H, and that one... Follow Triple H.
Thank you.
Excuse me, sir. Oh, shoot. What, will you hit the guy with the freaking hammer? Eat a dog, boy. What is he, made of steel? Give me a steel chair. Uh-oh, get up. Sucker. Triple H, what's up? You want to make my life a living hell? Come here! Pick up the kendo. What's up, sucker? Get him. Trips. That's not what I wanted to do. It's about time to be woken. I think that'll. Oh, God, that just came out of nowhere. You know. Can I throw him into the trash cans? That's kind of funny. Get up. Oh, I missed. How did it? Okay. Get the other one. Is there like a cutoff thing, like where I can't go any further, or? Yep. Alright. Get up! Okay. Oh. finish you now, Bray. Flip sucker. Wait, get Bray Wyatt to the Tempest Strike. Actor? Oh. Over here. Someone keeps screaming. Jeez, it's like a horror movie. Get Bray Wyatt to yellow health, then bring him to the porch of the... We're on the porch now. Now you don't. No, you don't, Mr. Wyatt. DDT.
He's got the whole world in his hand. He's got the whole world.
Oh, shit. I'm saying that's all I'm getting strength, Rod. Oh. Ow, right into the freaking chair. Jeez. Bray's giving me a run for my money.
Get up, Bray!
DDT! It's like he's pooping. Yes! Payback time, baby. Follow the Buzzards. The Wyatt family made their debut on Raw in July of 2013, victorious, attacking Kane. This would set the tone for Bray Wyatt's career in WWE. Kurt Angle. Uh-oh. Jason Jordan? What the... Thought this picture would make you feel better. Too stupid. What Bray did to you was sick. I hope you're okay. No, you don't want my help. But I'm here if you need to anything. I mean it. What happened? Are you okay? You know I'd be there in a heartbeat to come see you, but I haven't matched tonight. Try to call you again later. I am so weirded. I'm so worried about you. Please let me know you're okay. ASAP. No, some things like this wouldn't happen. Heard you're not feeling great after what happened with Bray. Let me know what I can do. Okay.
We have a huge show for you today, recapping everything that happened at WWE's TLC event. But the first thing we have to discuss is that encounter, for lack of a better term, between Buzz and Bray Wyatt.
I certainly wouldn't call it a match, that's for sure.
I've watched it a few times now, Hood, and I'm still not sure what really happened.
It was bizarre, to say the least. I mean, if I had a nickel for every time my opponent knocked me out with gas in the locker room before the match, then brought me to his creepy compound where I had to fight off all sorts of crazy things, only for it to end with the fire, then I'd be flat broke, because that just doesn't happen.
I mean, we're at a point where I'm questioning if the authorities should be called. Buzz was kidnapped, essentially.
You might have a point there, Pete. What happened has no place in wrestling.
Well, we're talking about a guy who's everything going for him, and now after what Bray Wyatt did, he might never be the same. It's disgusting.
Yeah, from what I hear, he's in a bad way, and it may be out for a while.
Uh-huh. Well, what do you think's going to happen with the title?
This is bigger than titles, man. We're talking about a man's career and well-being. You said it yourself. Buzz might never be the same after this. Bruises and bones will heal, but your mental psyche will not. It's times like this, I'm glad I'm retired, because I would want nothing to do with Bray Wyatt.
Yeah, hard to jump into the rest of the TLC card after that, so let's take a break, and then we'll try to get into it.
Yeah, that dude is nuts, man. Coming in like that.
How are you feeling today?
Not great. I'm sore, I have a nasty headache. I only remember bits and pieces of what happened.
Probably a side effect of whatever Bray Wyatt used to knock you unconscious.
Could also explain some of the things I saw out there.
A full recovery is what's most important right now. But unfortunately, we don't know yet how long that might take. So I have some bad news. Triple H is making me strip you of the Intercontinental Championship.
Come
due
on.
To the injuries you've suffered.
I'll make it back in time to defend the title. I know I can.
I believe you can too, but Triple H doesn't want to wait around and see. He said his decision was final. I'm sorry. I'll try my best to give you a chance to regain the Intercontinental title when you return. Now try to get some rest, okay?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think I'm going to stop it right here. And again, I get screwed out of another championship because of Triple H. First, the United States Championship with the RKO out of nowhere. And now I get stripped of the Intercontinental title. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that'll be it for the day. I want to thank you all for stopping by, and I also want to make a quick shout out to a good friend of mine, a mod in the channel on my broadcast. Her name is Sherelle1590. She's playing Shadow of the Tomb Raider, which is a really good game. Definitely go fan her up here on twitch.tv and YouTube. I'd like to say hello to all the new people out there, and welcome to the Chaos Asylum. So, share this video, leave a comment, hit the like button, and if you haven't done it already, smash that subscribe button and like button on here. And always remember to take care and spike your hair. You can't get a break. No, I can't, Sherelle. Later, guys.